To stack a cake, we're going to put some supports in this bottom tier, so it's important to know how big the top cake is going to be. I'm just very lightly marking a 6-inch pan, which is the size of the cake I'm placing on top. Now I'm making marks for where I'm going to insert my bubble tea straws. I'm using 5. You'd want 5 or 6 because this is a 6-inch cake that we're putting on top. For small cakes, it's okay to just make a circle. For larger cakes, you're going to need more than that for support, so you'd kind of have an inner ring and an outer ring. These straws are about 1 inch within that circle we traced, but I definitely recommend researching a chart for proper placement depending on the size cake you're making. Bubble tea straws are a very popular choice for supports with bakers because they're not only cost efficient, but they're cylinders, which are one of the strongest shapes. I've heard some controversy about using dowels because if you push a pole in that doesn't have a hollowed center, it just kind of squishes the cake, which I guess can mess with the structure, but I'm not totally sure on that because I've only used these bubble tea straws. Make sure you press them all the way down. If you're not entirely confident that you're going to make them all the same size, when you cut that first one, you can pull it out and then individually cut each straw to match it exactly and then put them all in, rather than doing this method here of kind of lifting and cutting, because it is really important that they're all exactly the same. So just do whatever you're the most comfortable with to make sure that happens. Okay, now here's my 6-inch cake. This was popped in the freezer for about 1/2 hour, so I'm using a hot knife to just loosen the bottom. I do recommend placing a cake in the freezer, especially if you use American buttercream, because it makes it a little more firm and easy to work with. Make sure your knife is going under the cake board, because we're going to need that cake board to be attached to the cake. I like to add a little bit of frosting to the bottom tier just to kind of create an extra glue. Now here's my favorite trick. I like to use a pole or a dowel, which I generally buy either at like Lowe's or Home Depot or even in the craft section at Walmart or a craft store. And I put it all the way in the cake because now I'll kind of have a handle. We can use a spatula to start picking the cake up. And this is an example of me not practicing what I preach, but basically I always use tape to adhere my cakes to the turntable, but you're gonna have to deal with peeling that off. Cake makers generally use a non-slip pad, but anyways, you can see how easy it was for me to move this by having that dowel. I centered it and also pressed down a little bit with that dowel because I don't want this cake to settle after. Sometimes if it's not pressed down, that can happen. And then I'm just smoothing out the edges here. This was really awkward to show. I'm just kind of trying to show you how I sharpen the end of my dowel because you need this to go through the cake board on top, and more importantly, you want it to go into that cake drum at the bottom. So I measure it to the right height. I do as close to the height of the cake as possible, and then I cut it, and I don't have real tools. I guess this is some sort of saw for drywall or something, but whatever. Make sure there is no loose pieces of wood on here and give it a rinse in case there's any dust. Now, I use my kitchen mallet hammer thing to hammer this right in. And another topic is I try to remember to put a hole in that cake board for the top layer, but I only started doing that recently. I always used to just nail or hammer the dowel right through that cake board and I had no problems with it. But definitely bonus points if you do remember to put a hole in your cake board first. I use that extra dowel just to make sure I bang it all the way through the drum and then cover it up with a bit of frosting. If you have any questions, leave them down in the comments because, again, I'm not a professional, I'm self-taught, and this is just what I do.